Please stand and join us in singing our entrance hymn number 172, Jesus Christ is Risen Today.
Jesus has risen, and that he will come to take us where he is in heaven. And so with that Easter joy, with that Easter hope, we gather together. We first acknowledge our sinfulness and ask the Lord for his mercy and his pardon. Lord Jesus, you are the everlasting judge of the living and the dead. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, you reconcile sinners to the Father. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the hope of your people. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest. In the highest.
Lord God, heavenly King, God.
us pray. O God, who on this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Holy Gospel according to John. On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning while it was still dark and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord. I'm always amazed at how quickly new terms or new words enter our language. They come into vogue. It's just one more sign of me getting old. Maybe they're trends, or maybe those new words or phrases are here to stay. Some of them, I think, come from pop culture. Some have other origins. I came upon one of them the other day that was new to me. I suspect some of the younger people here may have heard it, maybe not for those closer to my age. The term is doom spending. Doom spending. And it's closely related to doom scrolling. And now you're saying to yourself, nope, haven't heard of those yet. Well, let's start with doom scrolling. It refers to the act of mindlessly scrolling through negative news articles, social media posts, or other content sharing platforms. Essentially, it's reading one negative story after another. One study has called this social media panic. Some think it goes back to 2018. If you spend several minutes or perhaps several hours engrossed in reading stories or posts online, and they tend to be of the distressing variety, it's likely you spent time doom scrolling. One writer says, being informed seems like a good way to control what's happening around us, but it actually just creates more anxiety and fear. And why do we do it? He continues, the main reason is as a way of feeling in control in a world that feels so out of control all the time. And then related to doom scrolling is doom spending. It's a phenomenon that's afflicting millennials and Gen Zers who are, unsurprisingly, overwhelmed by the multiple world crises that we're currently facing. When we buy something, our brain releases feel-good hormones like dopamine and endorphins. One writer has said our consumer economy has long been predicated on making us believe new purchases will lift our spirits and solve our problems. They continue, young people have always been susceptible to overspending as they struggle with peer pressure and identity formation, but they are now more vulnerable to commercial forces than ever because of the dire economic situation they find themselves in. Both doom scrolling and doom spending, well, what do? They have us looking down, kind of looking down at our feet, a bit downcast. We experience the heaviness of the world. I suspect that one world problem, one local problem, one family problem, one personal problem has gotten any one of us in recent days or months drop our head down under its weight. They can be heavy. Problems in the world, the country, our neighborhood, our family, personally. And so we literally drop our eyes to the ground. Easter, Easter invites us to look up. Easter invites us to look up. St. Paul in our second reading says quite simply, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, your life, appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. Easter invites us to look up. When Mary Magdalene arrives at the tomb on that Easter morning, the stone is rolled away. She was downcast. Her head was down. She looks into the tomb. Jesus is not there. And then she runs to tell Peter and John, the other disciples. They run to the tomb. They see the burial cloths. The body is not there. And with reference to John, we're told he saw and believed. Peter, James, John, Mary Magdalene, the disciples, they were downcast because their leader, their master, their teacher had died, was crucified. All their hopes were dashed. They got to the tomb. He wasn't there. So they looked up. They looked up to the heavens. Their master, their Lord, their Savior had been raised from the dead. From the crucifixion, seeing Jesus suffer and die, the weight of that, the sadness, looking down, they raise their eyes and look above. They raise their eyes and look heavenward. My brothers and sisters, we've all experienced many things that cause our heads to droop, to become heavy for one reason or another, an illness, death, a disappointment, a broken relationship. So many things can happen to us. I asked a man last night, he came in, he told me his brother was very sick. Said, how's he doing? So he passed away this week. So he came to that Easter celebration, kind of downcast. Could be any one of us, eyes looking down. But on this Easter day, as we gather here, this day of joy, this day of hope, let us lift up our heads. Let us look up, see the Savior has risen from the grave. Alleluia, he is risen indeed. Easter today invites all of us to look up. Please stand. My dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so, now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God and the Holy Catholic Church. So now we renew our baptismal promises. Do you renounce Satan? I do. And all his works, I do. And all his empty show, I do. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? I do. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? I do. Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? I do. I ask you to remain standing as we are sprinkled with the new water blessed last night at our Easter vigil, blessed with the new Easter water.
precious.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen. Today, we rejoice in the passage of Jesus to new life. As we celebrate his triumphant victory, let us pray to the Father for our needs.
That the risen Lord may bless and strengthen his holy church throughout the world, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the efforts of world leaders may be inspired by the resurrection to help bring about true world peace, and to end poverty and help for those who are seeking jobs, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Easter joy may fill the lives of those who have entered into full communion with the Church through the sacraments of initiation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the comfort and recovery of the sick, and for all who suffer in any way, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the intentions of our parish circle of prayer, for those impacted by the coronavirus, and for peace in the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, especially all the deceased members of our parish family, that they may experience the fullness of Easter joy in the kingdom, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty God, in today's great celebration of the victory of life over death, we rejoice in the great work you have accomplished through your Son, Jesus Christ. Graciously hear our prayers and grant them through the same Christ, our risen Lord. Amen. Sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
One body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Bernard, and with all saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Richard, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only
only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Spiritual communion for those who will join us from their home. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at me spiritually into my heart. As though you are already there, I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. So let me never be separated from you. In addition to our usual communion stations, we'll have one station in the very back of the church near the baptismal font. Those who are in the metal chairs back there can go to that minister for Holy Communion.
Thank you.
church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that, renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord. A few announcements. We thank you for your weekly contributions. The baskets are there. The bulletins are there. Our Catholic Charity Drive continues. Great positive support. There are envelopes in the pews. Our bulletin has information about all kinds of good things happening for our 150th anniversary. I didn't mention in 1874, the priest came down from Our Lady of Mercy. They had Easter Sunday Mass in someone's house. Whose house is big enough? I don't think any of our homes are big enough, but this church is big enough, and we do still pray in gratitude for Father Dennis. We celebrated his funeral Mass earlier. He's the one who moved the church and this beautiful place we have to worship. And so for 150 years, St. Bernard Parish has been celebrating Easter Mass, looking to heaven. So thank you for being here today. For family members, friends, guests, you're always welcome. If you're just here in town, always come back to St. Bernard's. We congratulate the four people who received sacraments, adults last night, two baptized. All four of them were confirmed adults, young adults from the parish. And we also want to thank Allison and our youth choir. You anticipated it right away. We want to thank them for their beautiful music today. Allison with our adult choir, they were here last night for the vigil. They were here Thursday, Friday for the first Mass of our funeral. They've been busy this week, as we all have. But it's been a blessed week, and a week where we've been able to grow closer to the Lord. So every year I buy peeps. This year I'm looking out there saying, I don't know if I'm going to make it. So I'm saying grade four and younger, all right? I didn't eat any myself. I ate none. Grade four and younger. Peeps as you leave. Bottles of holy water. I think they might last, maybe one per household. They were blessed at the vigil last night. There's a young couple's night. It's our April event. There's a sign-up list. If you're a young couple, you know you are. In the last 10 years, you carried someone into church. You're a young couple. So sign up for our young couple's night, the April event. Take a look at the beautiful painting that's in the vestibule. Tom Lynch, a friend, an artist, has painted Mill Cove. Mill Cove here in Whitford specifically for our anniversary. It will be raffled at our dinner dance in June, but take a look at the beautiful painting that's in the vestibule. So a lot going on in celebrating 150 years. So we do thank the choir, Angelo, our parish staff, Christina, Dawn, working with the young people. We thank all of them. It's been a busy week, but a good week, and we do thank you for being here today. And finally, before the last blessing, you're gonna go to brunch, and they're gonna say, where's the joke? Well, here it is, I've got it for you. Three choices. What kind of jewelry does the Easter Bunny wear? 14 karat gold. How does the Easter Bunny stay healthy? Exercise, specifically aerobics. Finally, what do you call a line of rabbits jumping backwards? A receding hairline. We know. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Alleluia.